If you want an important character, well, it would be something else. But the way of becoming immortal, the idea is that they want to become immortal. Their name is immortalized. And they say these themselves being immortalized anyway. So this is how the new methods to become immortal have been invented. As I say, human being always wants to be immortal. But then the Vedas say that, Tyagen, na karmana, na prajaya, na dhanena. Not by great actions of producing things. Na prajaya, not by being having all your, the posterities, or the future generations. Na dhanena, not by wealth, that you can become immortal. All of these things are perishable. Tyagene ke amrutatvamana is by tyaga. Tyaga means yajna, by the sacrifice. Although Vedanta, tyaga means knowledge. Okay, that's all right, the ultimate sacrifice. Knowledge, ultimate sacrifice of your own self, ultimately. The ego, yajnena yajna mayajanta devaha. It's ego that is offered in the sacrifice on the fire of knowledge. Ultimate sacrifice. That's why cremation, sacrifice. This body, the final offering to the Lord, also final sacrifice. So therefore, this whole culture is based on yajna, sacrifice, which nobody knows here today. They all look at the West and imitate what they are doing, and then finding fault with this culture and criticizing it and so forth. But then, so this is the Panchagni Vidya, where the whole universe is looked upon as a process. Yajna is a process. Outcome takes care of itself, that's all. And so, this is how heavens is the first fire, that's what it said. Looking at the first footnote of Sava Gautama, He Gautama, Vai meaning Prasiddha, Asau means Dyulokaha, that the heavens, Agnihi, it is Agni, Ahavani Akhya, it is Ashti, Ahavani Agni, which is where the oblations are offered. The Garhapatya Agni, Ahavaniya, and Dakshinakhya, and other fires also can be there, up to five fires can be there, but three fires were common, and one fire was most common. Garhapatya fire is what is retained 24 hours a day. Ahavaniyakya, you take the embers from the Garhapatya and light of the kindle the Ahavaniya fire in the morning when you are going to offer oblations, and offer your oblations. And then that will get extinguished. And that Dakshinakya is for cooking certain food for pitrus and things like that. So for that is the third fire. But the fire where the oblations are offered is Ahavani. Therefore, hey Gautama, this heavens is to be looked upon as Agni, as Ahavani of fire. Ahavani akhya iti drishti kartavya. And so, you must have that drishti, you must meditate upon heavens as the Ahavani of fire. Iti evam agrebi drishti eva sarvatra vidaya. Subsequently also, it is drashti that is enjoined here, and not that an actual physical fire is going on, but the drashti is enjoined here. Okay, we'll continue tomorrow.
Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate Om Shanti 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 Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashyakrutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmedi Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyomavat Vyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namaha Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om.
असौ वै लोकोऽग्निर्गौतम तस्यादित्येव समिदः रश्मयो धूमः हरचिः दिशोऽङ्गाराः अवान्तरदिशो विस्फुलिङ्गाः तस्मिन्नेतस्मिन्नग्नौ देवा श्रद्धां जुह्वते तस्या आहुत्यै सोमो राजा संभवति असो वै लोकः अग्निः हि गौतम एस फुटनोट वन से असो वै दि हि गौतम वै मीनिंग प्रसिद्धः असो दैट द्यू लोकः अग्निः आहवनीयाख्यः इति दृष्टि कर्तव्या. सो इन दिस पंचाग्नि विद्या नाउ विच किंग जयवली प्रवाहन नाउ एक्सेप्टेड अग्री टू ऑफर टू उद्दालक. सो हे गौतम असो लोक दैट वर्ल्ड मीन द हेवन्स इज अग्नि. सो इन द पंचाग्नि विद्या दैट्स दी फाइव फोल्ड इन अमंग द फाइव फोल्ड फायर्स आहवनी अग्नि वेयर द आहुति इज ऑफर. So that is Ahavani Agni. That is the Dashtihi Kartavya. That is how one should meditate upon the heavens as the Ahavani of fire. Agrevi Drushtihi Va Sarvatra Vidheya. And elsewhere also subsequently, it is the, that it is not that the heavens is actually fire, but should be looked upon as fire and so forth. Tasya Adityaeva Samit means fuel of that Agni. Ahavaniya fire, Aditya, the sun is the fuel. Rashmayo Dhumaha. And the rays of the sun are in the place are to be meditated upon as a smoke emerging from this fire. Aha Archihi. And the day is to be meditated upon as Archihi, the flames. Dishaha Angaraha. The main directions, quarters, are to be meditated upon as angaraha, as the cinders, as they call it, you know. So, embers or cinders. Avantar dishaha, visulingaha, the intermediate space are to be looked upon as the sparks. Etasmin agnau, devaha shraddham jihvade. Tasmin, etasmin agnau, footnote 1 and 2, Evam Guna Vishishte Agnau. So, fire of this nature, namely heavens, which has all these various accessories in a fire such as that, Devaha Indradaya Saddham Jikhvati Dravyasthaniyam Saddham Jikhvati. So, in turn to that fire, the devatas make an offering of Shraddha as a very oblation. Tasya Ahutyai Somo Raja Samhavade. Now if the Tasyaha Ahutyai, then the footnote 4 is Panchamyarthe Chaturthyau. Then Tasyai Ahutyai. So this Tasyaha Ahutyai can be looked upon as two ways. Tasyai Ahutyai or Tasyaha Ahutyai, both of them will ultimately result in Tasya. So in which case, in one case, the I changes to A and then to A. In other case, the Visarga Lopa happens. So, Tasye Ahutyai, footnote 4 says, Panchamyarthe Chaturthyau Tasyaha Ahutyaha. From that Ahuti, Somo Raja Sambhavade. Footnote 5, Adhipatihi Pitunam Brahmananam Cha. So, the King Moon, who is the Lord of the mains as well as the Brahmanas, Sambhavade. Utpadyate, he arises, he is created, or he is born. So this is meditation. The Bhashya says, second line. So Bhashyakara said, Aso Viloka Agni Gautama Ityadi Chaturtha Prashna Prathamena Niniyate. That of the five questions that were asked, the fourth one is in fact here determined first. Karamangastu edan nirnayayattvaad itara prashnanirnayasya. Reason why this sequence is broken. So the first question is not answered first, but the fourth question is answered first, is because the determination of the nature of the remaining four questions depends upon the determination of this question, and therefore the fourth question is taken up first for being answered. Anandagiri says, in second line, so first was asau adityana, asau ityadina, yatithyam ityadi chaturtha prashnasya prathamya nirnaye kramabhangasyat. So after how many ahutis do these liquid oblations rise up and speak in the human voice, you know? So meaning that after how many stages these ahutis are offered here become human beings? Or this fellow Yajmana becomes human beings, that's what it means. Ityadi chaturtha prashnasya prathamya nirnaye kramabhangasyat. There will be a breaking of the sequence or the order. Tatrita karanam kavachyam. And you must tell us the reason why this order is broken here. Iti asangya kramabhangastu, Vashyakara said. Then Sri Anangari, manushya janmastitilayanam chaturtha prashna nirnayadhinataya tasya prahanyat prathamye sati arthakramam ashritya avivakshatasya pahatakramasya bhanga krutha ityartha. Manushya janmastitilayanam, this is how the ahutis depart, what is their path, and where do they stay, and how do they return, how they become human being, how it, again they depart from this world, you know, these sixfold questions are asked by the Janaka, and similar questions are asked here by also by the king to the boy, to Shvetaketu. So, manushya, janma, sthiti rayanam. Footnote verse 14 says, utpatte stradhinatvat jayam janmayatta sthidistatha sityapaye prayanam cha shutya bhedi karmastata iti vartikam vivranan bhashyam yojayati manushya chayanam. So, Vartika said, utpatte he tadhinatvat janmayatta sthidistatha. Utpatte creation depends upon this offering of the oblations. Janmayatta sthidistatha, the sthiti depends upon janma. Chityapaya prayanancha, and when the sthiti comes to an end, then there is a departure. Tataha shrutya krama avedi. That is why by the shruti, this krama, the sequence, is broken. Iti vartikam vivranvan. So this vartika is being actually explained. Bhashyam yavajati manushyadhyana. That's how Anandagiriji explains the bhashya. Tadadhinatvat turiya prashna nirnayatattvat, that determination of the other questions depend upon determining the fourth question. So going back to Anandagiri, manushya janmastitilayanam chaturtha prashna nirnayadhinataya. Since the birth and the existence and the departure of the human beings from this world can only be understood when we understand the answer to the fourth question. Tasya prahanya, therefore, the fourth question becomes the pradhana, the most important question. Prathamyasati, therefore, it is the principal question. Even though it is placed fourth in the sequence, it is a principal question. Therefore, arthakrama avikshitam ashritya avikshitasya pathakrama arthakrama ashritya. Therefore, Bhashyakara resorts to the arthakrama, the sequence of artha, sequence of how the thought flow takes place, you know. So, except that is accepted here. Avikshitasya pathakramasya bhangah krutah. So wherever artha is, artha krama is paatha krama baliya, and he said that artha krama is stronger than the paatha krama. So where sometimes, where artha, so explanation requires that we have to change the paatha or the sequence of presentation reading, then that is done there. Okay, now going to Bhashya. Asau Dyaurlokah Agnihi He Gautama Diloke Agni Drushtihi Anagna Vidhiyate Isayoshit Purushayoho Tasya Dilokagnehe Aditya Eva Samita Samindhanad. He Gautama Aso meaning Devhu Lokaha, Aso Lokaha Devhu the heavens. He Gautama is Agnihi, it is a fire. Meaning Duloke Agni Drishti Anagnau Vidhyate Anagnau Duloke Agni Drishti Vidhyate. So heavens, which is not really a fire, upon that the imagination of fire is being prescribed here. May you imagine or look upon that Duloka as fire. Same way elsewhere also in subsequent passages, Yatha Yoshit Purushayuhu, just as a woman or the man also, it will prescribe that they should be looked upon as fire as well in this five fire Panchayatna Vidya. Similarly here also, even though the world that is heavens is not really fire, it is to be meditated upon as fire. One should look upon that as fire. Tasya Duloka Agnehe Aditya Eva Samit Samindhanat. And so, of that Duloka Agni, of the nature of Duloka or the heavens, Aditya, the sun, is a fuel. So why is it so? Bhashyakar explains. Aditya Nahi Samidhyate Asau Lokaha. It's well known that Asau Lokaha. Footnote 8, Yatha Samidbhi Prasiddha Agnihi Tisheshaha. Yatha Agnihi Samidbhi. So, Samidhyade. So, just as the regular fire is kindled by the fuel, and so also the heavens, the fire of the nature of heavens, also is kindled by, here illumined by the sun. So, just as the fuel kindles the fire, so also the sun kindles the heavens or illumines the heavens. The samyak idhyate asau lokaha. So by the sun indeed, the world of heavens is indeed illumined. That is why. So some similarity is there. The idea is that for meditation some similarity must be there. And that is what Bhashyakara tries to provide here to facilitate this kind of a drashti of the meditation. Rashmayo dhumaha samidha uthana samanyat adityadhi rashmayo nirgataha samidhascha dhumo loka uttishtade rashmayo dhumaha. The rays of the sun are to be looked upon as the smoke emerging from the fire. Why is it so? Samidaha uttana samanyat. The smoke always emerges from the fuel. And here the fuel is sun. And from the sun, the rays are emerging. Adityadne rashmaya nirgataha. It's well known that the rays emerge from the sun. Samidascha dhumo loka uttishtade. And from samidha fuel, this loke dhuma uttishtade, in our world, that is our day-to-day life, the smoke emerges from the fuel, and the rays emerge from the sun, And therefore, between the fuel and the sun, there is similarity, and between smoke and the rays, there is similarity. That's why the rays are looked upon as the smoke.
Ahaha archihi prakasha samanya dishaha angaraha upashama samanya avanta dishaha visfulingaha visfulingavata vikshepa
aha archihi. The day is the flame, prakash samanyat, because the flame is bright and the day also is bright, therefore the day is looked upon as the flame emerging from that fuel.
Dishah angaraha.
Dishah, the direction, so the quarters, the four quarters, the north, south, east, west, are angaraha, that the embers.
Upashama samanyat.
See footnote number 10.
Jvaladi abhavaha.
Embers are those which are quiet, meaning there are no flames in there, and in the directions also there are no flames. Directions also means there is peace or quietude. So quietude in the directions, and the fire also has become quiet, you know, or is put out in those cinders, therefore the directions are to be looked upon as cinders.
Avantara disha,
the intermediate quarters.
So vidishaha,
they are also called the other directions, the corner directions.
Visfulingaha,
like sparks.
Visfulingavat vikshepat,
they are scattered, you know. So scattering being common between the corner directions and the sparks, therefore avantara disha. Those corners, those directions, are the intermediate directions, are to be looked upon as the sparks.
Then continuing.
So foot number 12 there was, Vishlishta Pratyaya Vedyatva Samyat. And so Vishlishta Pratyaya, what happens is, after one direction, then you have the quarter. Then a direction comes and a quarter. And then a corner. Again, direction comes corner. Therefore, they're like scattered. And then sparks are also scattered. In that way, there is some similarity between the intermediate directions and the sparks. Then continuing.
Tasmin, etasmin. Evam guna vishishte dyulokadnau devaha indradeha shaddham jukhvati ahuti dravyasthaniyam prakshipande tasyaha ahutyaha और तस्यै आहुत्यै आहुतेहे सोमो राजा पितृणां ब्राह्मणानां च संभवते.
तस्मिन् तस्मिन् एतस्मिन् एवं गुणविशिष्टे तस्मिन् एवं गुणविशिष्टे एतस्मिन् द्युलोकाग्नौ. तस्मिन् the fire, which is of this nature, as explained earlier, evam guna visheshte dulokagnau, this fire, which is characterized by being the heavens, agnau, in that fire, devaha, indradeha, shraddham jukhvati, Indra and other devatas offer shraddha as the very oblation in that fire of heavens.
Ahutyadi dravisthaniyam shraddham jukhvati prakshipande.
So shraddha is in the place of the ahuti, the material of offering, and that is being offered as very oblations in this fire by the devatas.
Tasya ahutye, meaning tasya ahutehe, somo raja, Pitrunam, Brahmanam, Sambhavati, and from the Rahuti, Soma Raja, king, Soma. So Raja means Adhipatihi. Here Raja means king or Adhipatihi, the Lord. Pitrunam, Brahmanam, cha. So moon is looked upon as the Lord of the Brahmanas and the means Sambhavati. Utpadyate. So moon is looked upon as the Lord of Brahmanas. Shankaracharya is looked upon as the Guru of the Brahmanas. So this is how they say, you know. Sambhavati utpadyate. This is the, that's how the king moon. Actually a body which is suitable for gaining experiences in the world of moon is created. That's what it means. So, as it is the first fire, a body which is fit for experiencing the pleasures in the world of moon is created. And then subsequently, other bodies are created. Now says Anandagiri, Indradinam karma anadhikaritvat dyulokasya cha ahaniyatva aprasiddhya Homadharatva ayogat tatyasya shuddhayaha homyatva anupattehe pratyas tasmin ityadi vakyam ayuktam iti shankate. This nothing makes sense, it looks, you know. So, indradenam karma anadikaritvad. So, indradeha shuddham jikhvati. The gods such as Indra and others, they offer Shraddha as oblation. But Indradhyanam karma anadhikaratvaad. Indra and other devatas are not qualified to perform karma. So there, the footnote number 9, karma anadhikaratvaadhi hotrutva anupattehidhi sheshaham. So they are not hotas, made a priest. So Indra and other devatas are not the nature of priests and therefore they are not qualified to offer ahutis. Only Hota. So only the priests are qualified to offer the oblations. And here on the other hand we are told that Indra and other gods offer oblations. They do not have the qualifications. Meaning that they are not the priests. So how are they said to be offering the oblations? Then Dyulokasya cha ahavanitva aprasiddhya. And Devaloka, meaning the heavens, is not at all known as the Ahavaniya fire. You know, it's not fire. Homa adharatva yoga, therefore, how can it become the adhar of the Homa? How can the heavens become the very place where ahutis are offered? So there, footnote number 10. Antahkarana vritti, and then, okay, Homa adharatva yoga, pratyasya cha shraddhayaha homyatvanupattehe. And what is shraddha? Shraddha is antahakana vritti visheshasya. Shraddha is nothing but a state of the mind. So shraddha is a thought or a state of the mind. How can that become the oblation? So pratyasya cha shraddhayaha homyatvanupattehe. Footnote 11, ukta homat Chandramasa, Utpatya Samhavad, Ityadavi Drashtavim, and further. So Shraddha cannot become Ahuti, it is not a material. It is just a state of mind. How can that become the Ahuti, material of offering? And you must add also that Ukta Homat, Chandramasa, Utpatya Samhavad, and from this imaginary Homa that you are presenting here, how can there be the creation of moon? That is also impossible. Ityavidashtavyam. So tasmin ityadi vakyam ayuktam. So tasmin etasmin agnau devaha shraddham jukhvati. This vakya vasuti is ayuktam. Doesn't seem to be proper. That is what the shanka is presented tatraidi. Vashyakara says now. Tatra ke devaha कथम जुह्वते किंवा श्रद्धाख्यम हवेहि इत्यतः उक्तम अस्माभिः संबंधे न
नतो एव एनयोः त्वं उत्क्रांतिम् इत्यादि पदार्थ षट्क निर्णयार्थम् अग्निहोत्रे उक्तम्।
तत्र के देवाः होम कर्म सप्तम्यर्थः। इन दिस होम कर्म, इन दिस एक्ट ऑफ परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ दिस फायर रिचुअल, तत्र के देवाः, हु आर द देवताज इंद्र एंड अदर्स हु आर डिस्क्राइब्ड एज ऑफरिंग द आहुति ऑफ द नेचर ऑफ श्रद्धा, हु आर दे, कथम जुह्वति, why is the nature of offering that oblation? Is something really offered in the real fire? Some real machine is offered in real fire? What's the nature of offering of this ahuti of the nature of Shraddha? Kyum va Shraddha kyum havihi? And also, what is the material of offering of Shraddha? So, havihi, footnote number 3, iti katham cha ukta homat somatpatti. Further question also. And how again is the creation of moon from a homa, from a fire ritual, sacrificial ritual, such as that? How can soma be created or may be immersed from that? Iti. All of these questions are there. Ataha. So, says Anandagiri, asya brahmanasya sambandha granthe samadhanam अस्य शोधस्य अस्मभि उक्तम इति आह। अस्य ब्राह्मणस्य संबंधक ग्रंथे, राइट इन द बिगिनिंग ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर ब्राह्मण भाष्यकार रिमाइंड्स अस ऑन द पेज 1465 एक्चुअली। अभी जो उक्तम अग्निहोत्रे न तो एतयोः उत्क्रांतिम् न गतिम् न प्रतिष्ठाम् न तृप्तिम् न पुनरावृतम् न लोकम् प्रत्युत्थानम् वेत्थयति। तत्र प्रतिवचने सो भाष्यकार रिमाइंड्स अस ऑल दैट दैट अस्य ब्राह्मणस्य संबंध ग्रंथे, सो द इंट्रोडक्टरी रिमार्क्स इन द प्रिलिमिनरी रिमार्क्स और इंट्रोडक्टरी रिमार्क्स ऑन दिस ब्राह्मण समाधानम अस्य चोदस्य अस्माभि उक्तम। वी हैव इन फैक्ट एक्सप्लेन द आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चंस इन द इंट्रोडक्टरी रिमार्क्स बिफोर दिस ब्राह्मण। फुटनोट नंबर 12, सार्व विभक्तिकः विभक्तिकम् तस्मिन् मत्वा अतस्य अस्य चोदस्य हविति अतः उक्तम अस्माभिः। Meaning, asya chodyasya samadhanam uktam asmabhi. We have told the samadhanam, we have resolved or answered these questions in the beginning of this Brahman, in the introductory remarks. Sambandhe yajnivalkyam prati janakah. So, in the dialogue between janaka and yajnivalkya. Natu eva. उत्क्रांति इत्यादि पदाशक निर्णयार्थम अग्निहोत्रे उक्तम। सो फुटनोट 5, सायं प्रातः अनुष्ठितयोः अग्निहोत्रायत्योः अग्निहोत्राहुत्योः एंड सो द टू आहुतिस ऑफ अग्निहोत्रा विच आर ऑफर्ड इन द मॉर्निंग एंड इवनिंग ऑफ दिस त्वं, सो जनका सेज टू याज्ञवल्क्य त्वं उत्क्रांतिम इत्यादि, सो यू डू नॉट नो how the ahutis arise from here and how on path they travel and so forth and so on. Ityadi padadha shatka nirnayartham. Footnote number 6, adina gatihi pratishtha truptihi punaravrutti lokam pratyutthai cha grishyande. So how the oblations arise, then gatihi, along what path do they travel, pratishtha, how do they remain in the world of pleasure or experience, truptihi, what kind of satisfaction they gain, punaravrutihi, how do they return to this world, and lokam pratyutthai, again, how they get converted into human being, and that fellow is really departed to other worlds. All of these were actually asked by King Janaka of sage Yajnavalkya. Sri Ramanagiri, Tadeva Darshetum, Agnihotra Prakane, Vrittam Smarayati. To show that, Vashyakara reminds us of what has gone by in the Agnihotra Prakana, Natu Iti, so that we already read. Kim Taduktam Iti Chet, what was stated there by King Janaka and in the Agnihotra Prakana also, Teva Iti. Says Vashya, Tevai ete agnihotra huti kute satyau utkramatah te antariksham avishadah te antariksham ahvaniyam kurvate vayam samidham Marichihi eva shukrama hutim te antariksham tarpayatah te tatah utkramatah te divam avishatah te divam ahvaniyam kurvate adityam samidham Ityevamadyuktam. This was stated by King Janaka actually. Bhashyakara has not said all of this, but King Janaka said this to Sri Yajnavalkya. Teve ete agnihotra hoti hute. Footnote 7. Teve ete ityadi. Apurva rupe khalu ahuti yajmanam utkramantam ashritya utkramatah. This was said earlier. When we read the part of Shatapatha Brahmana, Ahuti, these two Ahutis, Apurva Rupe, they get transformed into a subtle effect called Apurva, you can call. So they get transformed into subtle samskaras or subtle effect called Apurva. Yajmanam Utkrandam Ashritya. And they remain with Yajmana, the sacrificer. The sacrificer is not departing from this world. These Ahutis, which have transformed themselves into a very subtle matter, they envelop this sacrificer. Dhumadina yajmane antariksham avishatah. And then, Dhumadina yajmane antariksham avishatah. And they enter antariksham. So, when the sacrificer is traveling, you know, along the path of Dhuma, etc., these Ahutis along with him also enter heaven, I mean, the intermediate space, etc., ityadi bodhyam. So Ahutis get transformed from one state to the other. So going back to the Vashya, Tevai ete agnihotra ahuti, these two Ahutis offer an agnihotra fire, hute, Hute satya utkramatah. So Ahutis that have been offered in Agnihotra fire throughout the life, utkramatah, they depart from this world. Te antariksham avishatah. Those Ahutis then enter the sky or the intermediate space. Te antariksham ahvaniyam kurvate. Those Ahutis then use the antariksha, the sky, as a very ahvaniya fire. Vayam samidam, where vayu becomes the fuel, marichi eva shukrama hotim, and the rays of the sun become the white oblations. So white materials of oblation, this is how it was described. Tantariksham tarpayatah, and that way they propitiate the fire of the nature of antariksha. So antariksha is looked upon as fire, and vayu is looked upon as the fuel, and the rays of the sun are looked upon as the very ahuti. And that is how the fire of the nature of antariksha is propitiated. Tantariksham tarpayatah, te tatah, utkramatah. Again the two Ahutis depart from there. So disham avishatah. From antariksha, they go to the quarters. Disham avishatah. Te divam avishatah, they enter the heavens. Te divam ahaniyam kurvate, they again look upon the, or convert, or use the heavens as the very ahaniya of fire. Adityam samidam, where the sun is the fuel. Ittyamadi uktam. This, all of this has been stated in the Shatapatha Brahmana in the Agnihotra Prakarana. Footnote number 8 there. Ittyam ityadina te purvat divam tarpayatah te tatah avartete imam avishya tarpayitya purusham avishatah tatah strim avishya lokam pratyutthaya bhavati iti grihyate. So te purvat divam tarpayatah. Chandogya describes this, I guess, in pale detail. So the mantra in the Chandogya, so the bhashya, so tatraiva devaye tesham cha apakarana muktam tatraiva. Tevaite ahuti hute utkramatah tentariksham avishatah tentariksham ahaniyam kruvade vayam samidam marichiheva shuklam ahutim tentariksham tarpayatah tada utkramityadi emeva purvadivam tarpayatah te tadai avartete. So this bhashya is presented as footnote. So bhashya of in the Chandogya Upanishad on this particular section is presented as the footnote. Evameva purvat divam tarpayatah. And so in this, in the way itself, as before, they satisfy the divam, heavenly region. There is a soul of the sacrificer that is in the sky by bestowing the result. So antariksha, that it was first satisfied and now is transformed into heavens, is being satisfied there. Te tatahiva avartete, from there again, then they return. Imam avishya, return from there to this world. When the sacrificer soul returns, tarpayitva purusham avishatah, after having entered the world, having satisfied this world, prusvi. So from there, they come to Prithvi, that becomes other third fire, and in Prithvi also is being satisfied. And then, Purusham Avishataha, they enter the Purusha, the fourth fire, Tata Striyam Avishya, Stri becomes the fifth fire, Lokam Pratyutthaya Bhavati, and they get prepared to appear in this world, or depart from this world. Then, they are born as a human being, and they talk in the human voice. So how the ahutis, after how many ahutis, these material of the nature of the oblations, they get transformed into human voice. So panchamyam ahutau apaha ityam prashna prathamyan apakriya, the same thing. Then the fifth question was then resolved first in Chandogya Upanishad also. Okay, so that's good. Spashtam cha eta Chandogya Bhashya 541. That's what they say in Chandogya Bhashya. Okay. Now, Anandagiri in the last line says, Ahutyoho Svatantrayoho Utkrantyadi Kathamiri Ashangyaha. How come the Ahutis, etc., by themselves depart? How is it possible? Tatraidi, that Tatraidi on the next page. Page 1482.
तत्र अग्निहोत्राहुति ससाधने एव उत्क्रामतः यथा इह यैः साधनैः विशिष्टे ये ज्ञायते ఆహ్వనీయ అగ్ని సమిత ధూమ అంగార విస్ఫులింగ ఆహుతి ద్రవ్యై తే తథైవ ఉత్క్రామత అస్మాన్ లోకాత్ అముం లోకం.
ఇట్స్ ఇంట్రెస్టింగ్. తత్ర యజమానస్య మృతికార సప్తమ్యర్థః. సో వెన్ నౌ ది సాక్రిఫైసర్ మృతికార, when the sacrifice is prarabdha, is exhausted, and when he is dying and departing. Tatra agnihotra ahuti, these two ahutis of agnihotra offered in the morning and evening, sa sadhane utkramataha. It was said that when the sacrifice departs from this world, the ahutis that is also offered also accompany him. Accompany in what way? Sasadhane utkramatah. These two ahutis of Agnihotra accompany the sacrificer along with all his paraphernalia. All the various sadhanas or all the various accessories which are there, along with the rest of the accessories which are required to perform the homa or yaga, along with those accessories, the two Agnihotra ahutis, they depart or accompany the sacrificer.
శ్రీ రామనగిరి ససాధనయో తయో ఉత్క్రాంతి న స్వతంత్రయో.
ద ఐడియా వాజ్ హౌ డు ది ఆహుతిస్ దెమ్సెల్వ్స్ డూ దిస్, వెన్ దట్ ఆహుతిస్ బై దెమ్సెల్వ్స్ కెనాట్ హ్యావ్ ది ఫైర్ అండ్ ది రేజ్ అండ్ ది స్మోక్ యు నో స్మోక్ అండ్ సో ఫోర్త్. సో దట్ వాజ్ ది క్వశ్చన్ దేర్. ఆహుత్యో స్వతంత్రయో ఉత్క్రాంత్యాది కథం, డూ ది ఆహుతిస్ బై దెమ్సెల్వ్స్ డూ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దిస్. The idea is that ahutis accompany or take with them all the accessories, and that is why those accessories here get transformed into the appropriate accessories in those fires, and that's how this fire ritual or sacrifice is performed.
So, sasadhanayohoyeva tayoho utkrantihi.
These ahutis depart along with accessories. Na svatantrayo, not by themselves.
Yatha iha. Just as here in this world, yehi sadhanehi vishishte ye jnayate.
These two ahutis are well known. That these ahutis are known to be associated with various accessories.
Ahavaniya, this ahavaniya fire is there.
Ahavaniya agni, so fire called ahavaniya is there. Samid, fuel also is there. Then dhuma, the smoke also is there. Angara, the embers are also there. Visfulinga, the sparks are also there.
Ahuti dravyaihi, and the materials of offering also are there.
Then alone the ahuti oblations take place. So these, for oblations to take place, all these other accessories are also required. So we know these oblations as always associated with all these various accessories. This is how we know them here.
So yatha iha, tathaiva, in a manner similar to that.
Tathai means what?
So, yathokta sadhana vaishishtena,
as endowed with or as qualified with all these various accessories,
tathaiva utkramataha,
the two ahutis similarly also they depart.
Asmad lokat amum lokam.
From this world to the other world, the ahutis depart along with these accessories.
That is, when the ahutis accompany the sacrificer, The ahutis accompany the sacrificer along with all these various accessories, namely fire and the fuel and the smoke and the sparks and whatever. Iha iti jiva davastha uchyate. Just as when the sacrificer was alive, all these things were there. When he dies also, he carries all of these things with him. All of them accompany him. This is the idea. And say Ananagiri, Nashtanam Ajnadinam Avyagrad Bhava Apannatvena Avishesha Prasangat Nataihi Saha Ahutyo Utkrantyadi Siddhi Idyashanga Aha. Nashtanam Ajnadinam. See, what happens is that the fire has also now extinguished, the smoke also is not there, embers also are not there, none of these things are there. None of these things is there. So, nashtanam, ajnyadinam, avyakruta, bhavapannatvena, footnote then, anabhivyakta, nam rupatva iri bhavah. So, no more now there is fire or smoke or the fuel or the material of worship, material of offering. Nashtanam, ajnyadinam, avyakruta, bhavapannatvena. Since all of them have become now unmanifest. Anavivyakta nama rupatvena. The names and forms are no more evident. That being the case, avishesha prasangat. Egatvapatte. You can't distinguish now. Because there's no more manifest fire, no more manifest smoke, no more manifest fuel, no more manifest material of worship offering. And therefore, all of them become unmanifest. Therefore, you cannot distinguish one from the other. So, avishesha prasangat. Natahi saha ahutyo utkrantyadi siddhi. Natahi saha. Foot number 12. Natahi iti saha utkrantyahe bhinna dharmikatvadini bhavaha. If you say that these ahutis in fact carry all the accessories along with them and accompany the sacrificer, then you should be able to see all of them distinctly. So, but then, once all of them have served the purpose in Agnihotra, they no more appear here, they are no more visible or perceptible, and therefore, how they are no more, they cannot be distinguished from one another. That being the case, how do you say that? These ahutis in fact carry all the accessories with them. Sahutkrantehe bhinna dharmikatvat. If the fire and the fuel, all of these also were accompanying the ahutis, then they also should, they are naturally different from the ahutis, and therefore they must maintain their distinct nature. But the Agnihotra having been performed here, naturally these things are no more distinct from one another. Therefore, how do you say that the accessories also accompany the ahutis, along with the ahutis, accompany the sacrificer? So tatra agnihiti, then Vashyakara says, tatra agnihi agnitvena samit samitvena dhumo dhumatvena angara angaratvena visfulinga visfulingatvena ahuti dravyamapi Vaya adi ahoti dravyatve naiva sargadau avyakruta sthayam api parena sukshmena atmana vyavatishthade. It's interesting, you know, how tatra, footnote number 4, pralayavi. Suppose now the pralaya comes, the whole universe dissolves. What happens to all of this? Pralaya also comes when the yajmana dies, you know. Then also there is thought of a kind of pralaya for all of this. Or even if the whole cycle of creation meets with the dissolution, then also. Agni agnitvena it seems that the fire retains its fireness, samit samitvena, and the fuel retains its fuelness, dhumo dhumatvena, the smoke retains its smokeness, angara angaratvena, the embers retain their emberness. So ember is the illumined charcoal, cinder is the, what shall I say, the cold charcoal. So angara should actually be interpreted as, although it's translated as cinders, but angara is interpreted as, well as embers, because the red charcoal, red hot. Angara also means red color, anyway. So angaraka, that's why this planet Mars, it's called angaraka because it's red color. So angara, angaratvena, visfulinga, visfulingatvena, and the sparks also retain the sparkness sparks only. Sukshme, then ahudit dravyamapi, paya adi, ahudit dravyatvena. And the material of offering, such as milk, etc., also retain their form, such as milk. So, naiva, sargadav, avyakuravasthayapi, parena sukshmanatma vivatishtade. All of them remain, retain their distinctions. Sargadav, even in the beginning of creation, avyakuravasthayapi, even the state of undifferentiation, in the beginning of creation, all of these different accessories retain their individual nature. Parayana sukshmena atmana vivatishtade. And therefore, they obtain as in a very subtle form. Parayana sukshmena. Sukshmena atmana in a subtle form. Parayana sukshmena atmana in a very subtle form. Meaning, they cannot be distinguished. I mean, they cannot be perceived. They cannot be differentiated one from the other. So various footnotes were there. Tatra, footnote number 3, Nashottarakale. After the time, after their Nasha, meaning after they are no more in the same form, having served their purpose. Then footnote 4, Avyakravasthayapi, Pralayapi. Footnote 5, Parena. Atyantam, that parena is atyantam sukshmena atmana. So in a very subtle form, all of them retain their existence, distinct from one another. This is the idea. Siddhanagiri, nashad urdhumapi pratisvika shakti rupena ajnadi avatishtade. Nashad urdhumapi, even after their destruction, even after the death, meaning even after the conclusion of this fire ritual, pratisviga, footnote 14, pratisviga shakti rupenati sviya sviya asadharana sukshma rupenityartha. Each one of them retains their distinct characteristics in a subtle form. So pratisviga shakti rupena, shakti means a subtle form, really. So fire, etc. are manifest form. What is meant by shakti? Shakti means a subtle form. And so, sviya sviya asadharana sukshma rupena. That sukshma rupa, the subtle form is called shakti or the power, because it has the power to transform itself in the gross form. That's how the subtle form can be said to be the shakti. So pratisvika shakti rupena ajnadihi avatishtade. The fire and other accessories, they remain in their subtle form, having the power to manifest as in the gross form. Tathacha avishesha prasanga abhava. Therefore, when you accept this explanation, then it is not that they become indistinguishable from one another, but each one of them retains their distinction in a very subtle form, meaning that the total destruction does not take place. The fire and the fuel and whatever excesses are there, which were involved in performance of the Agnihotra sacrifice, none of those things really meet with total destruction. They do not become non-existent, but they continue to exist in a very subtle form, only to become manifest when the appropriate time comes. So Agnihotra performed once remains with you forever. That means we should imagine that whatever kind of acts of worship we perform, whether it is this puja that we do, whatever it is that we do, nothing ever gets destroyed. Each one of that gets transformed in a very subtle form and accompany us. So that is why they are called samskaras. All of these can be called samskaras also. As samskaras are as subtle, in the subtle state, they get embedded in the mind. So svasavasanam, sukshma sharira, the subtle body, is said to be savasanam along with vasanas. Vasana means the sukshma avastha. The subtle state of anything is called vasana. All of these, therefore, they accompany the yajmana. You might say that all of them remain in his own mind in the form of samskaras or the unseen memory, and they then become the, they manifest as the thoughts and actions and so forth and so on. Therefore, Anandagiri says, Ahutyoho sasadhanayoho eva utkrantyadi siddhihi. Therefore, Ahuti, along with the sadhanas, they depart. Otherwise, it is said that Ahutis perform the rituals there. They go to the sky and they look upon sky as the fire, and then the wire becomes the fuel and so forth. So how do they get the fuel, etc.? The idea is that all the fuel and everything which was here, all of it is available there, and therefore the Agnihotra fire here gets transformed into antariksha, and the fuel here gets transformed into vayu, and then the material of operation here gets transformed into maricha, the sun rays, you know. That's how all the excesses are available for the Agnihotra to be performed there. Again they get transformed to some other, you know, when they go to heavens. So these things keep on getting transformed as different accessories for the fire rituals to perform in different stages. So these ahuti of these yajmana keeps on performing this as they travel from one realm to the other. Then Anandagiri says, yathoktayohu ahutyohu utkrantyadi samarthanena Agnihotradi apurvasya jagadarambhatvam arambhakatvam uktam bhavati ityaha. Yathoktayoho ahutyoho. Footnote 15. Sasadhanayoho ahutyoho. These two ahutis which depart along with the accessories. Utkrantyadi samarthanena Agnihotradi apurvasya jagadarambhakatvam uktam bhavati. So utkrantyadi samarthanena Agnihotradi apurvasya jagadarambhakatvam uktam bhavati. So ahutyo utkrantyadi samarthanena. So by saying that this ahuti is in fact depart from here, Agnihotradi apurvasya and Agnihotra etc., all of them which have got transformed apurva. So apurvasya jagadaranamakatvam, it apurva means those samskaras in fact which create this whole universe. The universe gets created, you know, as they keep on performing the Agnihotra in different realms, different things get created. That's how the whole world is created. The Somo Raja, that he is created, different things are created, and all of this is going to be stated here, you know. And so then the Parjanya is created, and then the vanaspadis are created, and then the ahara is created, and the vidya is created, and then the child is created. That apurva gets transformed in all these different stages and ultimately becomes a human being. So apurvasya jagadarambhagatvam uktam. And so that it actually is responsible for the creation of this universe. The human being comes last, before that all these different stages are there. So by the time human being is born, the whole world is already created in all these different stages. iti uktam bhavate, and that is how it can be said that is the purva in fact that creates all of the whole universe. Tad vidyamanam iti Bhashyakara says. Tad vidyamanam eva. Should not be vidyamanatva. Tad vidyamanam. Tad vidyamanam eva. Sasadhanam. Agnihotra lakshanam karma. Apurvena atmana. Vyavasthitam sata. Tat punaha. Vyakarna kale. Tathaiva. Antarikshadina. Ahani adi. Agnyani bhavam kurvata. Viparinamate. Tathaiva. Idanimapi. Agnihotrakhyam karma. Tat vidyamanameva sasadhanam agnihotra lakshanam karma. So understand that agnihotra, the karma of the nature of agnihotra is all present. Sasadhanam along with all the accessories. Vidyamanam agnihotra karma that this yajamana sacrificer performed here has not got destroyed. It is existent in a very subtle form. And the whole Agnihotra karma, in fact, accompanies the sacrificer. And therefore, vidyamanam eva sasadhanam Agnihotra lakshanam karma, the karma of the nature of Agnihotra, along with the accessories, apurvena atmana vyavasthitam, in what way does it obtain now? That whole thing, Agnihotra, along with all the accessories, all of that remains with the yajamana in the form of apurva. Where everything is distinct again. The fire remains fire and the fuel remains fuel and everything remains everything, you know. And all of that in the subtle state is called apurva. And so apurva, apurvena atmana vyavasthitam sat, remaining in the form or in the state called apurva. Tat punaha vyakarana kale. When the time comes for them to become distinguished from each other, tathaiva antarikshadinam ahavaniyadi agnyadibhavam kurvat viparinamate. So when the time comes, then this fire, ahavaniya, gets transformed as the antariksha. And this samid here gets transformed as vayu. And the material of offering here gets transformed as the marichi. So that's how all of these things are transformed. So tathaiva, footnote number 6. Purva kalpa vadeva. Even if it is new kalpa, even if it is new, you know, cycle of creation, whatever obtained in the previous cycle of creation, in the new cycle of creation also, all of them obtain in the same form. Punaha vyakarana kale, when the time for manifestation or distinction comes at the beginning of creation. Tathaiva antarikshadinam. See footnote number 7. Antarikshadi iti antarikshadini ityadav prasamena adishabdena div prasvi purushayoshitangrahanam dvitiyena gahapatyadakshanatyayoho trutiyena aditya samidadinam grahanam antarikshadinam Ahavani adi, agnyadi bhavam. Two adis are there. Antarikshadinam, prasamena, adishabdena. What happens is, antariksha represents the fire. So, dyu, prithvi, purusha, yoshitam, grahanam. Dyu, the heavens, prithvi, the earth, purusha, the man, yoshit, the woman, all of these are to be included, are also to be understood, along with antariksha. Antariksha, Dyu, Prithvi, Purusha, Yoshit. So, thus this Ahavaniya fire gets transformed into all these different fires at the different stages. And then, Antariksha Dinam, Ahavaniyadi, Agnyadibhavam, Dvitiyena, then other Ajnani bhavam. What is Ajnani? Garhapatya Dakshinatyayohu. So Ahavaniya, Garhapatya Dakshinatyaya. All the three fires are required. Because Ahavaniya can be there only when Garhapatya is there. Garhapatya is the fire of Grihapati, which is maintained 24 hours, and from that you kindle the Ahavaniya. And then this Dakshinatya is used for performing special rituals, like when you make offerings to the mains, etc., you do cook the payasam, cook the kheer, you know, and so that payasam has to be cooked. And for that, you may have seen the priest sometimes cooking right here, on that fire itself, he cooks that payasam with milk, you know, and with the rice and so forth. So that, for that also you require this dakshinagni. So trutiyena aditya samidadinam. Antarikshadinam, Ahavaniyadi, Agniyadi, then Agniyadi. So Ahavaniyadi, that includes the Garhapatya and Dakshinatya, and Agniyadi. So Agniyadi means, then Aditya Samidadinam. So Agniyatrutiyena, Trutiyena Aditya Samidadinam. Then becomes the Aditya, the Samid, etc. So each one gets transformed into a corresponding material or accessory. Each accessory here gets transformed into the corresponding accessory at different stages. This is the idea. Kurvat viparinamate. So this is how the Apurva transforms each one of them in their respective form as required to perform that respective fire ritual. Agnihotra. Siddhan Nagiri, Vidyamatma Vishadevi Apurvena. Okay, Apurvena Atma. Then Siddhan Nagiri, Asa Yathoditaya Vidhaya, it should be, I think. Huh? Here it looks like Vishaya, but anyway. Yathokta yatha yathoditaya vidhaya. Kathamabhi purvakalbiyam karma pradayadashayam avyakradatmana siddham punaha jagadaravatam atha yathoditaya vidhaya. So by the manner which you described here, Kathamapi, footnote 16, Shrutyadi Anirdharita Pramana Visheshani Diyavada. So Shrutyadi Anirdharita Pramana Visheshana, it is not that Shruti specifically says this, but this is what we imagine must be happening. Kathamapi, however, so however all this thing takes place, okay? So Yathoditaya vidya kathamavi purvakalpiyam karma. You are saying that the karma that performed the purvakalpa, previous cycle of creation, prayadashayam avyakritatmanasthitam. Even the state of pralaya or dissolution, all of this remains in the undifferentiated state. Puna jagadarapatam. All right. So let that create the next world, next cycle of creation. That's how Agnihotra karma is responsible for, or you can say the Yajamana sacrificer actually creates the whole world. Saptannani pita janayat ajanayat. So what is it? Yat saptannani medhaya tapasa ajanayat pita. So how this pita, the sacrificer, created the whole world made of the sevenfold food. So punah jagat arabatam tathavi idanintamam idanintanam agnihotradikam karma kasam jagat arambakam. All right. So purvakalpiyam karma, the karma performed in the purvakalpa may be the cause of the creation of this world, but the action that agnihotra is performing now, idanintanam agnihotradikam karma katham jagadarambakam. How does this agnihotra karma that is being performed now, how does that become the cause of the jagat, the creation? Bhavishyati ashanka tathaiva. So that answer, that shanka is replied, tathaiva. So Bhashyakara said, tathaiva idanimapi agnihotrakyam karma. If that, just as that agnihotra karma of the previous cycle caused the creation of this cycle, so also agnihotra karma of this cycle will become the cause for the agnihotra karma in the future cycles. So Anandagiri says, tathaiva, footnote number 8, purvakalpiya karma deva, like karma performed in purvakalpa, idanim tanam api, even the present day agnihotra karma also, Anandagiri says, vimatam, arambhakam. So the agnihotra karma at this time, being performed at this time also, is arambhakam, is also the cause of the creation. Tachaktimatvat, sampradipannavat idibhava, tachaktimatvat, footnote 7, arambhashaktimatvat. So this agnihotra karma has the same potency as agnihotra karma of the past. Therefore, it having the same potency also has the capability of creating the next world. So vimvatam arambhakam. Therefore, the agnihotra karma that is under the dispute is also arambhakam, is also the cause of creation. Tat shaktimatvat sampradipannavat. Like the agnihotra karma of the past, which is accepted by both the parties as capable of creating this world, similarly also this agnihotra karma has the same potency also. Therefore, it can also create the world. It's also has the capability of creation. That's how the whole universe is created by these ahutis. This is what is said in Agnihotra Prakarana. Okay. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Bhadarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah. Ishvaro Guru Ratnevi Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyomavat Vyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namaha. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om. Let us read Kandika on the page 1479. Asau vai loko gnir gautama tasya aditya eva samita rasmayo dhumaha Aharachi Dishongaraha Vantara Disho Vispulingaha Tasminne Tasminnagnu Deva Shraddham Jukhvade Tasya Ahutyai Somo Raja Sambhavade Asau Yulokaha Agnihi Gautama Ityadi Chaturtha Prashnaha Pradhanjena Niriyate. The Shruti refers to answer the fourth question first. That means the king Pravahana gives the Upadesha to Uddalaka, Gautama, and start with the fourth question. Kramhangastu edan nirnayaya tattvat itara prashna nirnayasya. The reason why the krama, the order has been in fact broken, is because the determination of the rest of the questions depends upon the determination of the fourth question. That's why.
Asau dyulokaha agnihi he Gautama. Dyuloke agni dashtihi anagnau vidhiyate.
In fact, the world which is heaven, which is not fire, upon that, the drashti of the fire, meaning one may look upon the heavens as the ahavaniya of fire. This is what is vidhiyate, what is enjoined.
Yatha yoshit purushayoho,
just as later on the man, woman, etc. also, the drashti of fire, which are not fire, but they are to be looked upon as fire. Similarly also, this is what the Shruti enjoins, looking upon the heavens as a fire.
Tasya dyulokagnihi adityah eva samindhanat.
Of the dyuloka, or the heavens which is fire, adityah, the sun is the fuel. Samindhanat, because it very, very well kindles. So, the heavens is very well kindled by sun.
Adityenahi samidhyate asavlokaha.
It's well known that the world which is heavens is illumined by the sun.
Rashmayodhumaha samidha utthana samanyat.
And the rays of the sun are called dhumaha, they are called the smoke, because the smoke arises from fuel, and the fuel here is the sun, and the rays arise from the sun, therefore there is a similarity there.
Adityadhi rashmayohi rashmayo nirgataha samidascha dhumo loke uttishtati
aha archihi prakasha samanyat. And the day is looked upon as the flame because of the similarity of the brightness.
Dishaha angaraha upasham samanyat.
The dishaha quarters, the directions are looked upon as the very embers or the cinders, because both of them are quiet. I mean, there is no flame, is something that is active, and the angaraha, the cinders are quiet. Or so if you say cinders, then they are all been put off. If you call them the embers, then also they are quiet, there is no flame, and so the directions, quarters also are quiet. So because of quietude, that's the similarity.
Avantar dishaha visfulingaha visfulingavat vikshepat.
The intermediate quarters are looked upon as a spark because of the scattering, which is common. The intermediate directions are scattered.
Tasmin evam guna visheshte dyulokagnau deva indradeha shraddham jukhvade.
In this fire, which is a dyuloka, the world of heavens, the devaha indradeha, the devas, gods and indras, shraddham jukhvade. They make an oblation of Shraddha. So Shraddha becomes the material that is offered.
Ahuti Dravyasthaniyam Prakshipanti. Shraddha is in the place of the material that is to be offered.
Tasyaha Ahutyaha or Tasya Ahutyai Ahutehe Somo Raja Pitrunam Brahmananta Sambhavati.
And from that Ahuti called Shraddha, Somo Raja,
the king which is Soma, he emerges.
Tatra ke devaha katham jukhvati kim va shraddha kim havit yatah uktam asmabhi sambandhe.
So Vashyakara himself raises this question.
Tatra ke devaha,
in this kind of a sacrifice that is taking place there in the heavens, the Indra there, who are the devatas in fact who are offering the ahuti of the nature of shraddha?
Katham jukhvati, what's the mode of offering? What is meant by offering the Shraddha Ahuti?
Kim va Shraddha kyam havihi?
And what is meant by the havihi?
The material offering called Shraddha.
So what is that? So this is the question here. With reference to that, we already said in the introduction here,
नतु एनयोहो त्वम उत्क्रांति मित्यादि पदार्थ चटक निर्णयार्थम अग्निहोत्रे उक्तम इन द अग्निहोत्र द स्टेटेड द सिक्स फोल्ड थिंग्स सो ते वयेत अग्निहोत्राहुति हुते सत्य उत्क्रामत सो वेन दिस अग्निहोत्राहुति इज ऑफर्ड देन उत्क्रामत द डिपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस वर्ल्ड द अंतरिक्षम आवेशत द एंटर अंतरिक्षम द इंटरमीडिएट वर्ल्ड और द एंटर द स्काय द स्पेस द अंतरिक्षम आहवनीयम कुर्वादे दे मेक द अंतरिक्ष द स्काय इज अ वेरी फायर वायु समिधम एंड द वायु द एयर इज समिध द फ्यू मरीचि शुक्राम आहुतिम एंड रेज सनार द व्हाइट ऑब्लेशन दिस इज ऑल द This is the kind of fire that is described in Chandogya Upanishad, not here. But anyway, because the Vidya are the same, so Vashyakara refers to that. Or maybe this is what may have been there earlier, I don't know. Tentariksham tarpayataha, and that is how, by offering the ahuti of the vayu, or vayu the samid, and the shukram ahutim, shukram the marichi, so marichi are the ahutis, and that is how antariksham tarpayataha. So that's how, they in fact satisfy the fire called antariksha here. This is what is going on there. Titatah utkramatah. Having now quenched or satisfied the antariksha fire, then they ahuti again depart from there. Te divam avishatah. They enter the world called the heavens. Te divam ahaniyam kurvade. The heavens is now looked upon as or converted as a fire. Adityam samit there. The sun is a fuel. Ityadi evam ityevam adi uktam. This is stated there. Tatra agnihotra ahudi sasadhane eva utkramatah. Now Vashyakara explains what is all of this. So tatra agnihotra ahudi sasadhane eva utkramatah. When the ahudis are said to depart from here, it is said that they depart with all their accessories, they depart. Yathaiha yehi sadhanehi visishte ye jnayate. So these two ahutis here also are understood to be associated with whatever accessories are there. These ahutis are possible only when the accessories are present. Ahavaniya agni, ahavaniya agni, samid, dhuma, angara, visfuranga, ahuti dravyehi. When can the oblation be offered? When all of the accessories are present. So Ahavani Agni, when the fire called Ahavaniya is there, then Samit, when the fuel is there, then Dhuma, when the smoke emerges again, and then Angara, again the cinders or embers are there, Visfulingaha, the sparks are there, Ahuti Dravyam, the material of Ahuti is there. When all the accessories are there, then alone it is possible to make an offering. And therefore these Ahutis that are thus offered, depart from here along with all these various accessories. This is what Bhashyakara says. Te tathayo utkramatah asman lokat amum lokam. From this world, they go to the other world with all these paraphernalia. Tatra agnihi agnitvena, samit samitvena, dhumo dhumatvena, angaraha angaratvena, visfulingaha visfulingatvena, ahutidravi. Paya adi ahuti dravyatvenaiva sargad. So, that means that the fire as fire, the fuel as fuel, is the dhumha, then smoke as smoke, and the sparks as sparks, and embers as embers, and also the material that is offered, that also remains the material of offering. Sargado avyakrutavasthayapi parena sukshmina atmana vivatishtade. All of these retain their individual existence. The idea is that each accessory retains its individual existence, doesn't get mixed up. At the beginning of creation also, even though nothing is distinguishable, avyakruta, then also in avyakruta, indistinguished state, they retain their individual existence. Parena sukshmina atmana in a very subtle form. Tad vidyamanameva sasadhanam agnihotra lakshanam karma apurvana atmana vyavasthitam. That is the whole karma, the whole ritual of agnihotra is present. In what form? Apurvana atmana. So that Parayana Sukshmena Atmana is the Apurvena Atmana, as very Apurva, in a very formed samskara, the whole Agnihotra ritual is present. That is how it departs. Vyavastitam sat, tat punha vyakarana kale, tathaiva antarikshadinam ahvaniyadi ajnyadi bhavam kurvat viparinamate. And then this whole Agnihotra ritual which is present in the form of samskara, the impressions, so when then the ahutis take place or the sacrifice takes place in the heavens, etc., then all these different elements which are here, they get converted into corresponding elements there. And so, as the table shows subsequently, what will happen is, for example, the fire, ahvaniya fire, will become the heavens. The fuel which is here will become the sun. The smoke will become the rays of the sun. The day will become the archahi, the flame. The dishaha, the quarters, will become the embers. The avanta, the intermediate quarters, will become the visfulingaha, sparks. Then shraddha will become the havihi, become the material of offering. And from there, the king Soma arises, is born. So, all of these will get transformed in corresponding form there. This is what Bhashyakara has to say. So, punaha vyakarana kale, when the time comes for the manifestation of this creation, tathaiva. Purva kalpavat eva, like in the previous kalpa, the previous cycle of creation. Antarikshadinam, footnote number 7, Antarikshadin ityadav. So Antarikshadinam, Ahvaniyadi, Agnyadi, three adis are there. So Prathamena adi shabdena, Div Prathvi Purush Yushitam Grahanam. So Antarikshadi, then first is, so then, by the word, the different kinds of fires. So, prasamadi shabdena, dew, first fire. And then, prithvi. And then, one is missing there, parjanya. So, since intariksha is included, therefore I guess the parjanya is not included here. But then, dew, this world means, I am loka means prithvi. Purushaha. And yoshit means muvan. So these are to be included. So in subsequent stages, the very same thing get transformed, you know. They become, the idea is that that's how the whole world is created. From these ahutis that are offered here, this Agnihotra karma alone gets transformed with all these various accessories in all the different sacrifices, and that's how the whole world is created. Dvitiyena, and then ahvani, swantarikshadi, ahavaniyadi, dvitiyena, garhapatya, dakshinatyoho. Then, this ahavaniya, garhapatya, dakshinagni, all the agnis also, they take their corresponding forms. And ajnyadi, dvitiyena, aditya, samidadadina. So, other accessories, fire is one accessory, then fuel and so forth and so on. So, rest of the accessories also will assume their corresponding forms. Bhavam kurvat viparinamate, and thus they get transformed into all these forms in successive stages as the cosmic sacrifice, the fivefold sacrifice takes place. So Anandagiri said, Atha yathoditaya vidhaya kathamapi purvakalpiyam karma prayadashayam avyakrutatmana sthitam punaha jagadarabhatam. Yathoditaya vidhaya, in the manner in which you just described, kathamapi, however, shrutyadi anirdharita pramana visheshaniti avata. This is our own, Bhashyakara's own kalpana, because this is not specifically stated in the Shruti, and therefore, this is presumed, you know, so this is like artha bhakti. So kathamapi, shrutyadi anirdharita pramana visheshena, And so Shruti, Smriti, etc., the Pramana is not there to say this. So Kathamapi.
Purukalbiyam karma pralayadashayam avyakratatmana sthitam.
Purukalbiyam karma. The Agnihotra-adi karma that is performed, then it will be stated later that it is not only Agnihotra, all kinds of rituals that are performed here, all kinds of sacrifices are meant by Agnihotra. But Purukalbiyam karma, so karma or the action, that is ritual that is performed in the previous cycle of creation, pralaya-dashayam avyakrita-atmana-sthitam, in the state of pralaya or dissolution, that karma remain as avyakrita, then differentiated as apurva, punah jagadarabhatam, and then made then create this whole world by getting transformed through success.